out in your pocket. Oh, that was a tough battle. So, Mondo Mole, see what the internet says about him. Mole. He's got 498 hit points. I feel like I did more damage to him than that. He's vulnerable to PSI flash and paralysis. So I got paralysis. Maybe I should use both of those. Try that next time I get to him. Ugh. That was much tougher than anticipated. Buy a bunch of croissants. No, I don't want a cold remedy. That was a mistake. I need to load my pockets with croissants. Inventory management is actually one of the most difficult parts of this game, which is a little bit unusual. But like most games with inventory management as a major function, like the amount you can carry is still kind of ridiculous. It's like, I have like 10 croissants in my pocket. I mean, you do have a backpack. I guess you could squish 10 croissants into your backpack. It might be a little bit, yeah, squished, but you could. If you were so inclined, stick that many croissants into your backpack. Okay, so now that our pockets are stuffed with croissants, let's put this money away so I don't lose it all again. Once more into the breach. Yeah, so I think the thing is to use PSI flash and PSI paralysis. Hopefully, once those are both done, I can actually beat him. But he was tough. I mean, he did a lot of damage with his claws. I don't know how I usually beat him. I thought that he was weak to ice, but apparently not. That should help. My offense is up by 4 now, so should be a little bit of extra kick. Maybe enough to get me through that battle. The leveling up in this game is not linear. It's sort of random and predetermined. those two words make a lot of sense together, random and predetermined. But, like, what you get from each level is predetermined and non-linear. It's, you know, completely different each level. So some levels you'll get, like, 2 HP and you'll be like, well, that was dumb. In other levels you'll get, like, 50 HP and a whole bunch of other stats. So you never really know. I think it fits for a quirky game like this. You know? In a game where people, you know, maybe are more prone to, like, optimizing, it would be annoying, but, you know, this isn't a game that I think lends itself to optimization. I know that people do speedruns of Earthbound, and far be it for me to, you know, imply that that doesn't make sense, but it certainly isn't how I play this game. I think, you know, people will do speedruns of any game, and they should, because that's, you know, if that's what they find fun. I just enjoy the game for the game. I don't do speedruns in anything. I'm not just not that kind of, you know, real competitive gamer. Also, I probably would be bad at it. Although, that's not a reason not to do something. Even if you're bad at something, you can still try to do it and get better. It's just not something that I'm inclined to do. Bring down the mighty bear. I could really do without all this clawing, you know? Eat a croissant. Mighty bear became tame. Someone, like, briefly started watching and then went away. See, you guys think you can sneak in and sneak out and I won't notice. But when no one is watching the stream, I notice. You can't get away with it. Not that you're trying to get away with anything. Mr. Batty is sizing up the situation. Mr. Batty feels strange. Okay, now her damage is high enough that she can actually kill some things, at least when she gets smash attacks. I mean, Paula's offensive physical capabilities, you know, are never as high as really any of the other characters. Certainly never as high as Ness's are. But she's useful with her psi abilities, and, maybe mainly her psi abilities. It's not like there's some other things she can do. Her prayer ability is, like, honestly pretty bad. I've tried using it, and it often does more harm than good. It's only really useful in its spoilerific usage, which is, you know, it's how you beat the final boss. You have to pray 9 times to beat the final boss. Injecting a little bit of religion into your goofy Super Nintendo game. Mighty Bear became tame. I'm actually kind of interested in watching a speedrun of this sometime just to see how they get through stuff quickly. So yeah, I think I'll need croissants to preserve my peepee. On the one hand, it feels a little bit, like, exploitative to keep saying pee-pee, but I mean, that's what it's called in the game. I don't know what else to call it. So, let's see if we can beat him this time. I'm skeptical, but take it from me, if you dare. Mondo Mole attacked. So let's use PSI Flash, and then none of your things seem to do anything, but let's try fire before he gets his shield up. That wasn't much damage, but... And now let's try Paralysis. And since that didn't do much, let's try Thunder. So Mondomole is now paralyzed. It could be he can't hurt me anymore. I don't actually really know what Paralysis does. I mean, he's just healing himself right now. It looks like I may have completely neutralized him. Yeah. Well, that's the answer to how you beat Mondomole then. Is you paralyze him. I mean, he's still, like, probably out-healing my damage, to be honest. But... Presumably at some point he'll run out of pee-pee, and then I'll be able to beat him to death. Doesn't seem very sporting of me, but hey, he killed me the first time. Mondomole became tame! You won! It's a lot of XP. So it gave me one level. Okay, we each got one level. So now Paula has Psi Magnet. Or PSI Magnet. I think it's PSI because I remember in Smash he yells PSI Fire! PSI Flash! They don't say Psi. My sanctuary location. Oh, I'm supposed to walk out of here. I was just standing there for no reason. The beautiful music. My ears uncomfortable. Gobi briefly had a vision of a baby and a red cat. Gobi's soundstone recorded the melody of the Lilliput steps. So, that also fully heals you. For what it's worth. I'm curious. These guys will not run away from me. Do I just instantly win? I do not. So... I'm not going to, fight all these enemies in here. Just for fun. Let's, use this exit mouse. It's like the first time I've ever used an exit mouse. Woo! As long as I'm here, I should probably sleep again. I did lose a very small amount of HP fighting that bear. Gonna go back out through the Peace Forest Valley, and I'm trying to think. I don't really feel like going through the next portion right now. Finally, I have a chance to apologize. The next portion is, go through the Peace Forest Valley, and then, from there, head to Threed, by riding the bus with, what are they called, the Runaway Five. I'm inclined to save that for next time. I think, I've done actually quite a bit today. I think this sits on its own as a portion. I may have made more sense a little bit to have had the whole